will check in for Mason Siren. Harris, right in front of us, picks up his dribble.
Another good trap.
Lobs it ahead to Hines. Hines goes in against Stalnicker. No charge, no block, no basket either. Quick outlet the other way to Wilson, and he will lay it up and in. Quentin Wilson has four in this quarter, and the lead's out to 20.
I'm impressed with the defense, and I'm also impressed with the transition. They are running the floor very well.
Hines will get this one to go. Tayshawn Hines gets his first basket of the game. Big Red's working it around.
Nice.
Nice cut to Stalnicker, who goes off glass and good. Andrew Stalnicker's first basket of the game.
Little showtime there.
This is as crisp as we've seen the Big Reds move around.
Again, the defense is on task right now.
Robinson, the only one to go in after the basket, and he gets his first points of the game. Wilson cherry picking on the other end, and nobody saw him, and he's got three straight baskets. Does Quentin Wilson timeout capital? Coach Green is losing his mind.
He
over
said,
there.
"I have seen enough."
And yes. He'll burn his second 30-second timeout. Wilson literally standing right in front of him, and he's the only one in blue that saw him.
And luckily, the inbounder saw him too, because it was a pinpoint perfect pass.
They would say, that's a beaut. If your name was Clark, it would be a beaut, Clark. A beaut.
Seven Nations Army's playing.
It is. It's always playing somewhere. That's a theory that I have, is that somewhere
that's
there is an arena or a stadium or something that has people in it. That song is playing.
Sometimes
it's like, and without the world, like there's always a game somewhere.
And sometimes I hum it when I take the trash out.
Dun, 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 dun.
It's a production.
Cougars trying to get it in the lane. Off balance shot from Harris.
Nothing easy right now. Nothing easy.
Big Red's into the front court, and Robinson grabs it away from Wilson, and we got a whistle. And it is going to be the first foul on David Robinson. First one of the quarter. Team foul of the quarter. Andrew Stalnicker gets it into Rodriguez with 5 minutes to go until the half and a 20-point Big Red lead. Andrew Stalnicker to a cutting Daly into the corner to Wilson. Back out to Daly. Lines up a three, and he shorts that one. Grant Barclay for Capital there to let it go out of bounds and make it Cougar ball.
I don't know. I think you keep shooting like that, you're going to have to bench him. No, just kidding. He's 5 of 6 in the first quarter, folks, from three-point range.
Boy, yeah, five straight three-pointers. Here's a three from Likens. Back of the iron, no good. Rodriguez goes up for it. Nobody's going after these rebounds. There's not a soul under these baskets when they're coming off the rim. Rodriguez can't get it to go, but Matthew Stalnicker spins it back up in, and he's got 10.
That was a big boy play right there by Stalnicker. He fought off the Cougar to get to that basketball and make the shot in.
Robinson going to be fouled before the shot, and I believe that's going to go on Andrew Stalnicker. His first, team's first.
You are correct, sir.
Wilson will come out. We'll see Isaiah Walker check back in for the Big Reds. Lob out top, trying to get it to Likens. Picked by Daly. And it's a foot race the other way. And Hines knocks it away but steps on the end line.
That was good. That was a good job by Hines just to trail the play. PHS is doing so much, blocking off all the lanes. So that means inbounds have to be kind of like punched over the top. And now they're even getting the hand on those, too. That was almost a straight interception off of that inbound.
Elijah Bennett in for Cam Harris for the Cougars. And now we'll see Ja'Cory Clark in the game for the first time tonight. As Robinson checked out. Inbound is loose on the floor. We're going to get our first tie-up of the game, and we will. Arrow will be in. in favor of the Big Reds.
Capital said, all right, I saw that play once, so we're going to try and get into the passing lane there. The Stonecker brothers running that patented inbound play that they have.
Andrew Stonecker tries to get it into Walker, but picked off. Likens full steam up the floor to Clark. Just checked in and hits his first jumper.
I say, man, cold off the bench and hot to start.
Rodriguez will drive in and charge called. That's going to be Nate's third.
And the sad part about that was that the
guy
didn't need to. It was a good job by Barclay. He wasn't even in the play. He kind of just jumped in, stood next to them, took a glancing blow, but he was set technically, and he fell down. So the main defender that was in front of Rodriguez didn't fall. So it was a good job. It was just a good job there to just get into the play by Barclay.
Here's Barclay for three on the other end, and he nails it. Second triple of the game for Grant Barclay. He's got eight. Nate Rodriguez checking out. Mason Siren replaces him in the Big Red lineup. Stonecker has it knocked away. Loose basketball on the floor. And we're getting another tie-up.
Yep. Two consecutive held balls, so it goes right back to Capital.
Cougar ball, Tayshawn Hines to inbound.
They get a shot here. It's going to make things interesting. I always say you get it to 10 points at any point, you've got a chance. And I know that's only first half, but Capital has got it.
Would you say the Cougars have clawed their way back into this one?
I would indeed. Matter of fact, I need to pay you royalties now.
Here's Hines on the other end, can't get it to go. Quickly the other way for the Big Reds, and it's Isaac Daly laying it up and in. 17 points for the junior.
First high percentage shot that he's attempted and made it.
Big Reds making some hay off these transition baskets. Their defense is definitely leading to offense as Elijah Bennett charges down the lane and gets the easy layup. Walker into the corner to Daly. That one won't go. Walker with a putback won't go. Walker with a putback won't go. Bennett ahead to Hines. Barclay, three from the wing. Ooh. Hits another one. Grant Barclay has three triples. And timeout Coach Wilson and the Big Reds. They'll burn their first 30.
It's frenetic. It's all over the place. And the thing is if they can get past that first wave, They got a pretty good chance. Barclay has had a couple of really good looks from three. It's just getting it to the arc. But they have done that successfully over the last few possessions, Capital has. That's how they've gotten back into this game. They're only down 14.
Barclay started the game shooting threes. Couldn't get anything to go in. Now he's starting to find his range a little bit. And feeling good about it. First, he's the only Cougar in double figures. He's got 11.
I have him for 3 of 6 from three-point range, so that's 50% is a good number when you're a shooter.
The lead is still 14, but it was well over 20 not that long ago.
They are back into this game, and really you would think that with everything that's kind of gone bad for them right now, you'd surprise where they're at.
Siren will force the issue, can't get it to go. Stonecker's put back, not there. Loose basketball controlled by the Cougars. Hines will push the other way. Drops it to Barclay. They close out on him, not giving him the three, so he goes in, can't get it to go off glass. Hines follows up. His shot won't go. Loose basketball collected by Hines in front of the Big Red bench. Barclay for three. Won't go. Big Reds get it out of there. Matthew Stonecker will lay it up and in. 12 points for Matthew Stonecker.
Wow.
Barclay tiptoed in front of the scorer's table, but saves it into the Big Reds. Here's Daly. He will lay it up and in. Points. 19 points for Isaac Daly.
Yeah, points off of turnovers are always a killer stats.
We saw in the JV game, the Cougar JV team just could not get out of their own way, just kept turning it over. And the varsity team is fallen victim to the same thing as Tayshawn Hines lays it up and in. He's got four. The lead is 16 with a minute to go until the half. That was probably a walk. Daly gets away with it. Pass inside, picked off by Bennett. Loose basketball gathered back by Siren.
Excellent
to
hustle.
Daly, to Matthew Stonecker with another layup.
And that play happens with the hustle of Mason Siren.
Slip and fall by Bennett, and they're going to call a jump ball, and possession goes with the Big Reds. His feet just came out from under him. I don't think there's any wet spots out there, Mike.
No, he just fell. I know he was trying to politic for a call of some sort, but there wasn't anything to be called.
Cam Harris will check in for Tayshawn Hines with 36 seconds to go. Siren trying to get a screen from Matthew Stonecker. And an offensive foul is going to be called on Mason Siren. Shove off.
Okay. Yeah, I did not, the way his body was positioned, I didn't see that.
Yeah, I believe it was a shove off.
Trying to get that extra separation.
Keon Likens to Cam Harris. Ahead to Bennett. Bennett gets the floater to go. Elijah Bennett has 6 points. So we're closing in on 10 seconds to go here in the second quarter. Daly in the corner. He'll go baseline, tries to wrap it around. 2-1. Likens gets it off, but missed everything, and that's how we'll go to the half. Big Reds got spotted 18 points to start this game, but the Cougars have stayed in it 45. They just changed it to zero. 29? Now it's 193. 45-29. We'll go to the half. We'll take a timeout. Well, maybe we'll see the Red Wings here in a little bit. You're watching high school basketball here on CAS 45.
Every day people ask me, is now a good time to retire? Any day is a good day to retire if you have a plan, but you have to have a plan. For a lot of people, retiring is one of the scariest things they'll ever do. Stop in. Ellicipia takes some of the scariness away.
True story. Nothing else feels like college basketball.
This is star power from the jump.
The electric environment.
This building is alive right now.
The unforgettable moments.
What a play.
The stories unfold night after night. Men's college basketball all season long on the networks of ESPN.
Thank you. Are you still debating between regular makeup and permanent cosmetics? Start the year makeup free and get your eyeliner or eyebrows done for an incredible price of $300. That's 50% off of our regular price. Come and visit Le Chalet for the best permanent makeup experience in the Mid-Ohio Valley. And remember, beauty doesn't happen by accident, it happens by design.
When you call the Basement Doctor West Virginia, you know you've called the right place. We'll help you solve the worst problems in your basement or crawl space, from bowed walls, cracks, to water, mold, and more.
Our experienced and well-trained crews will carry out the repairs, leaving you with a drier, cleaner, healthier, safer, and more energy-efficient home. Plus, you get a lifetime transferable warranty.
You can trust the Basement Doctor of West Virginia. Call now at 877-DRY-TIME or visit basementdoctorwv.com.
Bowling and Dunn Family Dentistry can't wait to see your smile. When you take care of your mouth, every expression is an expression of good health. A healthy smile is a powerful thing. That's why you should come visit us. Our relaxed atmosphere will make your visit stress-free. Young or old, the key to good health is right under your nose. Call today to schedule your appointment. Your smile is in good hands. Bowling and Dunn Family Dentistry. Get ready to change the way you feel about dentistry.
WVU Medicine Camden Clark's pediatric team is here to help you turn belly aches into belly laughs. Now accepting pediatric patients at our new location in South Parkersburg. It's big care for small patients. And that's the power of WVU Medicine. WVU Medicine Camden Clark's pediatric team is here to help you turn tears into playground cheers. Now accepting pediatric patients at our new location in South Parkersburg. It's big care for small patients, and that's the power of WVU Medicine.
At the half, it is PHS 45, Capital 29, as the Big Red cheerleaders are out there now. We had future Red Wings attended a little camp showing off what they'd learned. How come you weren't out there? You went to the camp.
I think I pulled a hammy. I couldn't do the kicks.
I heard you flunked kicking, but that's fine.
That's all right.
Scoring-wise, first off for the Big Reds, led by Isaac Daly's 19. 15 of that coming in the first quarter when he hit 5 3-pointers in a row. Matthew Stonecker with 14 points. 8 of those coming in the first quarter. on easy layups when he was wide open. Quentin Wilson added six on three straight layups. Nate Rodriguez had four, and Andrew Stalnicker with two. For Capital, led by Grant Barclay, got hot from the three-point line. 11 points for him. Elijah Bennett with six. Tayshawn Hines with four. David Robinson with two. Keon Likens with two. Tylee Tinsley with two. And Ja'Cory Clark with two. Had the Cougars not spotted PHS an 18-0 lead to start the game, they played them square in the second quarter, Mike.
Much better. Shot better. I mean, if you look at both teams, put up a total of 50 or 65 shots in that first half. You don't usually see that many shots attempted. PHS in that first quarter, they just went completely bonkers with their shooting, 10 of 15. The end of the half at 19 of 32, that's 59%. People dream about having that nice of a shooting percentage. They're doing that, and they didn't shoot near as good in the second quarter, but good shot selection finally. Like I said, Capital, their problem is getting there. The defense from PHS has been pretty spot on, but if they can get past that mid-level and actually get it to really not even so much the low post, if they can just get it to one of those perimeter shots, they got good perimeter shooters, the Cougars do, and they, in that second quarter, much, much better. So they've been able to keep it from being so just completely out of hand.
Yeah.
And right now, I mean, really, it's 14 at this point is not too bad. Or 16 at this point, not too bad.
No, considering it was 18-0 at one point. The Cougars went on a couple of runs, caused Phil Wilson, the PHS head coach, to burn a timeout. So the Cougars are they haven't put up the white flag. They're not done yet. They didn't drive this far to phone one in. So PHS better stay on it. The Big Reds have rotated probably 12 guys through this game already.
Right. Keeping a lot. I mean, it is. I mean, and the way that they're playing defense right now does expend a lot of energy. So, you know, coach is definitely doing his part to just keep everybody as fresh as they can. But yeah, the defensive effort for PHS has been spot on. And again, they had that huge scoring run to start the game, so that's always nice. But sometimes when you get a little frenetic with your defense, sometimes those little cracks can be found. Capital, again, once they get past the trap, and they've done it a few times in the latter half of that second quarter, they've hit pay dirt. So they just got to keep doing what they can do to get past the defense and keep hoisting those shots to see what happens.
Starting five for both teams out there. Robinson, Likens, Barclay, Hines, and Harris for Capital. The Stalnicker brothers, Daly, Wilson, and Rodriguez for PHS.
And don't forget Rodriguez, three fouls.
Capital starts with the ball. Hines into the corner. Barclay for three, and he's already hot. Grant Barclay has 14 points in this game.
Good pure shooter. Our sample size of seeing him in the early part wasn't good, but he's definitely gotten better.
Rodriguez fires it under to Matthew Stalnicker, out to Daly. Cannot answer back. Andrew Stalnicker with the rebound. He can't get it put back. He follows his own shot. Blocked, but a whistle, and he'll go to the line to try and get him the hard way. Foul is going to go on Cam Harris. That's his second, team's first.
We have only seen two free throw shot in this whole game. So this is
it's amazing. With as fast as they've been playing, yeah, two free throws is it.
Ooh.
Members roll for Andrew Stalnicker on the first one. Misses the second. Pinballs around in there. Andrew Stalnicker goes to the floor. Excuse me, Matthew Stalnicker goes to the floor. Jump ball, arrow favors the Big Reds.
Stalnicker was flat on his back. And there was a lot of bodies surrounding him. Could have called a travel on that. I'm glad they didn't. But it definitely was a possibility.
Stalnicker to Stalnicker, but out to Daly. Long three is well short and will go out of bounds. Capital basketball.
He has been something magical tonight, but when he's missed, it's been really bad.
Harris will bring it up the sideline. Back to Hines.
They are doing
pressure
a great
from
job.
The Big Reds. Yep.
Just
Likens pull up in the lane is not there. Sky for the rebound is Andrew Stolniker. Rodriguez to Daly. Andrew underneath to Matthew. Kicks it out to Wilson for three. That hits the top of the backboard. Knocked around in there, and Harris comes out with it for Capital. He will go to the rack. Can't get it to go. Robinson and Hines collide, and the ball's knocked away. And we got Stolnikers by themselves down here. Matthew leaves it for Andrew, and he lays it up and in. Hines, nice fake.
Wow.
And he will lay it up and in.
That was nice.
Tayshawn Hines has 6 points.
So much going on around that. For him to be able to concentrate and get that done.
Robinson going to be called, I believe, for the reach. Tried to smack that one away. It's going to be Robinson's second foul, team foul two. The only one in real foul trouble in this ball game is Nate Rodriguez, who sat a lot of the second quarter with three.
Yeah, he picked up that third off the charge.
Rodriguez leaves it for Daly. That three is also short. Andrew Stolniker with the putback, not there. Knocked around everywhere. Whistle goes with the Big Reds. And it almost looks like Daly's legs are he's not getting, they're short. Everything he's putting up is short. As a quick inbound to Rodriguez gets laid up and in, and Nate Rodriguez has six.
Sometimes it does kind of get into your head a little bit. Like, he's had a couple of bad misses, and it's just a recorrect. And he just was just so stratospherically good in that first one, in that first period.
Robinson is going to be fouled on the baseline on his shot. That's going to go on, I believe, Matthew Stolniker.
It was, yes.
His first, team's first. Big Red lead is 16. At one point, it was as large as 23, I believe. Robinson, the first free throws attempted by Capital tonight. He makes the first one. Elijah Bennett will check in.
They're doing a great job of just
for
Likens around.
I'm sorry. Yep.
They're doing a great job of just hanging around right now. They're doing what they have to. They're surviving very well, putting up some good shots. And again, once they get that past that first wave, usually good things happen for them.
Robinson misses the second. Outlet pass down the other end is picked off by Robinson, and a whistle. And I think we're going to have a trip on a Big Red.
Daly.
His first. Team foul two. Big Reds will go with about three-quarter court pressure here. Harris and Hines will get it across the midcourt stripe. Robinson goes baseline. Floater won't go. Rebound, Andrew Stolniker. Ahead to Wilson. Finds Matthew Stolniker to Daly in the corner. Tries to hit Andrew Stolniker. Picked by Harris, and a whistle, and I think they're going to get Andrew Stolniker for a reach, his second, team's third. So Capital's not getting a lot of points, but the Big Reds are racking up some fouls.
And they have not been hitting with the same shooting percentage as they did in the first half.
Cougars move it all the way around the arc to Barclay, cuts inside, in and out of the cylinder. Rodriguez with the rebound. Andrew Stolniker ahead to Daly. Wilson will curl in. Jumper's too strong. Harris collects it for Capital and a whistle. As we have a Cougar down, I believe that is Barclay, well behind the play, other end of the floor, actually. He's on his feet, but not too sure about it, as the trainer will come out and help him off, but trailed the play. Cougars still did pretty well defensively.
I was going to say, I didn't even notice that they were down a player.
Barclay is going to be helped off the floor. Going to be replaced, I believe, Likens will check back in for the Cougars. Capital ball after the foul, trailing by 15.
PHS 2 of 9 in the quarter.
2 of 9?
2 of 9. But really, I mean, the comeback is not really we're not ready to book that just yet because Capital is 2 of 7 in the quarter.
Bennett trying to get it to Likens. Lost out of bounds and an unforced error on the Cougars.
You used the jargon that I was getting ready to say. I mean, so many good things have happened over the last 8 or 9 minutes for Capital, and then to lose the possession on that.
Wilson to Matthew Stoneacre. Rodriguez will pull the trigger on a three. It's short. Daly collects it. Back out to Rodriguez. Nice no-look pass underneath to Andrew Stoneacre, who lays it up and in. He's got 7. Lead back out to 17.
Tell you, PHS, too, I mean, even despite how Capital has kind of fought back into this, I still am really enjoying PHS's offensive rebounding. They have had lots of second and third chances today.
Nice move by Bennett to get loose underneath, and he'll lay it up and in. Elijah Bennett with 8 points tonight for the Cougars. Matt Stoneacre waits for Robinson to fly by, lays it up and in, and draws the foul anyway. And it's going to go on Robinson.
Now he has 3.
So Robinson will check out, and we will see Tyleek Tinsley, number 4, check back in. Andrew Stoneacre checking out for the Big Reds, and Isaiah Walker back in. Matthew Stoneacre at the line to shoot one, and he hits it. 17 points for Matthew Stoneacre, and most of that coming about 3 feet away from the basket.
Yeah, he's worked very hard on the low post tonight.
And the ball's going to be stolen away from Likens, but a whistle. You call a foul or just out of bounds? They just called it out of bounds.
Out of bounds, right. I guess.
Hines to Bennett, back to Hines for 3. In and out, no good. Rebound by Tinsley. Back to Hines. They still can't get it to go. Hines still following up with it. He'll go back up with it. Off glass and good.
Persistence. Second and third opportunities.
And Rodriguez will pick up his 4th foul. So we'll see Mason Siren come back in for Rodriguez. Isaac Daly also checking out. Chandler Jackson into the game. And now we have 6 Big Reds.
I was going to say
all
that.
Right, Rodriguez got to go out, yeah.
Somebody did not give him the memo.
Tayshaun Hines with 8 points at the line to make it a 3-point play and get the lead back down, and he does, to 15. Only 3 free throws shot tonight by the Capital Cougars. Here's Siren over to Walker. They'll get it across the timeline, but he throws it into the student section, tipped out by the Cougars. I didn't see who got a hand on it.
I think it was Hines.
Okay. Into the poncho section.
Definitely, it was a definite redirect. It was a good job, too, by Jackson to decide, all right, I'll let that one go.
Here's Mason Siren for the Big Reds. Called upon to run the point here for Nate Rodriguez, who's been in foul trouble a lot. Here's Daly for 3, and he finally finds the range again.
You had to figure he was going to do it again.
22 points for Isaac Daly. Hines weaves through traffic. That is a 3 off the mark by Likens. Put back by Bennett is good. Elijah Bennett has 10. Cougars trying to press. Big Reds will break it. Jackson picked from behind by Hines.
He set that up. He did a behind-the-back dribble right as the kid was going by.
And Hines goes in strong. Can't get it to go, but put back by Tinsley. Tinsley has 4. The lead is 12.
14.
14.
But a steal off
the inbound.
Now
the lead is 12. Bennett gets the floater to go. And another turnover. Here's Harris to Bennett. He lays it in. And the Cougars are rolling. Timeout, PHS. It's a 10-point game, Mike, with 1:53 in the third.
That was four consecutive turnovers, and they waited until the fourth one to call the timeout. Uh-huh. I would have called it a little earlier than that, but, yeah, just in this quarter alone, Bennett for Capital 4-for-4, and they're all off of turnovers, all layups.
14 points for Elijah Bennett, 8 of it in the last 40 seconds.
Yes. Straight steals. Oh, my goodness.
We thought the Big Reds, you know, Isaac Daly goes down and hits a three. And then it's just boom, 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 Capital, Capital, Capital. So what was a 20-something point game is now a 10-point game. This is as close as the Cougars have been since it was 0-0.
And there's still some time to work with in this quarter. PHS has gotten very careless with the basketball. Really, I mean, Capital swarm into the ball, but it's a lot of these, I used the term earlier, unforced error. There's been a lot of that in this quarter for PHS.
Four, Tinsley, 10, Hines, 2, Likens, 21, Harris, and 5, Bennett. Your 5 Cougars on the floor.
And now full court press
Siren,
once again.
Walker, Wilson, Daly, and Matthew Stoniker, your 5 Big Reds on the floor. Press from the Cougars, now numbers for the Big Reds in the other end. Matthew Stoniker can't get it to go. Walker with the rebound out to Wilson. He'll fire the 3 from the top of the key. It's not there. Rebound Capital. Cougars want to run. Likens drops it off to Hines, who lays it up and in and gets fouled.
Single digits. And we still got 1.5 minutes left in this quarter.
Foul is going to go on Isaac Daly, his 2nd, and we'll see Tayshawn Hines, excuse me, at the line for the 2nd time this quarter, 1 of 1. Andrew Stoniker will check back in for the Big Reds, and Isaac Daly will head to the chairs, and Hines has a chance for back-to-back 3-point plays here. And we've got a 7-point game.
And we also have a team that is brimming with confidence right now.
Brimming. That's a good word.
I like that word.
Exuding. Also a good word. Full court press from the Cougars. Mason Siren trying to get it in for the Big Reds. He'll get it into Wilson, and he will be immediately fouled by Likens. The Cougars are going full-on aggression here.
You know what? They don't need. I mean, they have gotten back into this game without doing that. So that was that's a silly foul.
Foul goes on Likens. It's the 4th team foul in the quarter. Inbound goes to Wilson. Wilson is going to be fouled going across the midcourt stripe. It was a little out of control, but the foul is going to go on Cam Harris.
Now he has 3.
That's his 3rd. Yep, and that is over the bonus now.
They have been able to get back into this game without having to do that. So that's 2 consecutive plays now. They're just being, I don't know, overly aggressive. I don't know if there's a way to truly gauge that or not. But I think those are 2 unnecessary fouls, and that's going to put Wilson to the line.
Shooting 2, and he hits the 1st one. Wilson, 7 points now, 6 of it in the 2nd quarter. As is Harris checking out? He did check out. Who came in? No, he didn't check out. He's just in the back.
No, he's still walking back there.
Wilson misses the 2nd.
But Stoniker got the offensive rebound and another quick foul.
And the Cougars are losing all their momentum. I believe that was Tinsley. I think he said 4. And that is going to put Andrew Stoniker at the line to shoot 2. Did they announce the foul? I think it was Tinsley.
They did not announce it.
It had to be either 4 or 5 as Andrew Stoniker hits the 1st one. 2 of 3 Harris will check out now, and Barclay back in. Good to see him back into the game for Capital after checking out with an injury. And Andrew Stalnecker hits them both.
Needed both of those.
Lead back out to 10.
Ooh,
Likens dancing on that midcourt strike, gets it to Hines. Hines, big jump stop over to Barclay. Just in and hits a three. Grant Barclay. 17 points and timeout Capital.
And back to a 7-point differential. Yep, he must go.
Well, it has to be a full timeout. They're out of 30s. Back down to 7 points with the lead as Grant Barclay, who we haven't seen for a few minutes of gameplay, left with an injury, comes back in and drains a three. He's got 5 of those tonight.
11 of 19 shooting in this quarter for Capital. That's what's got them back in. VHS has had a few opportunities from the free throw line, but that balance sheet doesn't work out when you're getting the ones compared to twos and threes on the other side.
Been a 25-point quarter for the Cougars. By far their best of the evening. And coming out of the timeout, it'll be Big Red Basketball. Andrew Stalnecker to inbound.
Right now, PHS has just got to find, well, something happened with the clock. It moved about two. It moved from 106 to 1 to 10.
And now they have 192 points.
It's 191 to 61. I don't remember them making that many baskets.
Yeah, you'd think we'd notice. All right, do over.
Mulligan.
Cougars call off the pressure until they get across the midcourt stripe. Now they'll pick it back up. Walker to Stalnecker, back to Walker out between the circles. Zone from the Cougars, and a three is good from Andrew Stalnecker, who has had quite the quarter. 10 points in the quarter for Stalnecker. Cougars come back down and a layup for Tinsley.
See, now I don't know. I know they're getting in a little bit of a foul trouble here, but I don't think the Capital needs to dial it down that much. Oh, almost a bad pass. They just need to lay off the fouling a little bit. But they've almost let PHS take that this final minute, this final full minute of the game and they are of the quarter.
Maybe they're resting up for the fourth.
Stocking up.
Siren to Walker, Stalnecker, Wilson, Andrew Stalnecker. Siren for three at the horn and hits the side of the backboard. We'll go to the fourth, and we've got a game, 64-56. Fourth quarter coming up next. You're watching high school basketball on CAS 45.
Welcome back to Crown Decor and Gifts, and welcome back to your happy place. With the new year comes a new fresh look at Crown. Is it time to spruce your home up with some new bright home decor? Or maybe it's time for a fresh candle or soap scent. At Crown, we've transformed the store for winter, and don't forget, Valentine's Day is around the corner, and we have you all ready to go. And new for 2024 is our Walnut Creek Mercantile, featuring Amish-made cinnamon rolls, cheeses, salsas, peanut butters, beef sticks, honey, and more. It's time to come back and see us at Crown Decor and Gifts. Welcome back to your happy place.
Hey everybody, join Discovery World on Market for their After Hours event for adults. Our 50s Sock Hop event will be Saturday, February 17th from 7 to 10 p.m. Tickets are $25 and include admission into the event. Soda shop sips, classic diner eats, rock and roll music, and a stroll down Lover's Lane. Costumes encouraged but not required. Prizes awarded for the best costume. To get your tickets, visit dwonmarket.org or Discovery World on Market's Facebook event. 50s Sock Hop After Hours, a rock and rolling good time.
Back here at the Fieldhouse, Brian Guthrie, Mike Cameron.
These two teams put up 39 shots during that quarter. 39 shots. 12 of 21, Capital was. 2 of 3 from three-point range. PHS was 6 of 18 for the quarter, 2 of 9 from three-point range.
Matthew Stonecker has 17. Andrew Stonecker has 12. Isaac Daly has 22. For PHS, Elijah Bennett has 14. Tayshawn Hines has 12. And Grant Barclay has 17 for Capital. Cougars outscored the Big Reds 27-19 in that third quarter. An eight-point game. I remind you, PHS started this game on an 18-0 run. Cougars working it all the way around, and Bennett's shot won't go. Rebound by Andrew Stonecker, and Rodriguez will slow things up as PHS trying to eat this clock up as much as they can, as they have basically turned themselves over in this ball game. And another out of bounds. Oh, and that one's going to stay with the Big Reds. Close one there on the far sideline. But the more aggressive PHS is on offense, it seems to be creating the offense for the Cougars.
Right, exactly.
Rodriguez, long jumper, off the mark. Rebound, Matt Stonecker. And a foul on the floor before the shot. And it will be on David Robinson. That is his fourth.
Yeah, I think Coach Wilson's saying take as much time per possession as you can. Don't hoist up a three-pointer like Rodriguez just did. But right now they have that Stonecker.
And Andrew Stonecker will hoist up a three. He's got 15 as he hits another one.
There you go.
15 points, 13 of that in the second half here.
You can get those to fall. That's good living right there. But, you know, you still want to take time per possession.
Cougars got to get a good shot, and they got to be able to follow it if it's off. Here's Barclay for three. He answers right back. Grant Barclay has 20 points for the Cougars.
I tell you, he and Daly both are putting on clinics out here.
They like the wing. They like the wing.
I like the wings.
You're a wingman yourself. Rodriguez can't get it to go, but Matthew Stonecker cleans it up. He's got 19.
I guarantee Matthew Stonecker probably has anywhere from 7 to 8 offensive rebounds. I guarantee he's double figures.
Here's Bennett for three, and he nails it. Elijah Bennett, 17 points, 11 of it in the second half. Good gravy. Daly from way deep, too strong. Tipped out to the Cougars, and Likens collects it. Barclay for three. Got it! 23 points for Grant Barclay.
And the lead
is
at four.
Timeout, PHS. I think they're going to take a 30 here. Yep. So now each team with two full timeouts remaining. And Mike, if you'd have told me at this point of the game it would be a two-possession game, I'd have called you a liar after that 18-0 run to start the game. It looked like Capital didn't even get off the bus.
I wouldn't have said that because it was, you know.
That would have been ridiculous for you to say that.
The proof was in the pudding in that first quarter. I mean, it was – I mean, PHS shot the ball well. They played defense well, too.
They were just clicking.
Yeah.
We said this was as in sync as, you know, we've seen this machine run. I mean, everything was working. I don't know what happened to make the wheels fall off the wagon, but Capital
didn't give up for
they
one
just
thing.
They kept clawing,
and they're shooting the ball much better. Obviously, in the second quarter, in the second half, they're playing much better defense. And PHS on the other side too. I've got to call out shot selection right now. I mean, I think they need to be working low post, taking as much time per possession, but they're. They're settling for a lot of jump shots, and they're not falling.
Rodriguez is short. Rebound Capital. Bennett tries baseline. He's cut off.
There you go.
Has his pass picked by Rodriguez. Matthew Stonecker the other way. Missed the layup. Loose basketball goes into the ponchos, and it stays with Parkersburg. It is poncho night in student section. So that's what that –
There you go.
I'm not just throwing out words for no good reason. Big Reds to inbound in front of their own students and lobbed into the backcourt to Rodriguez to eat just a few more seconds off the clock. Stutter step from Rodriguez, and he's going to be fouled on his way to the basket.
Now, I do like that. I do like that because they've been settling for a lot of jump shots, a lot of, like, deep perimeter shots, too. Rodriguez said, nope, this time we're gonna go right at him. If I don't get the shot, they're at least going to walk away with a foul.
Likens picks up his second foul, team foul two, and Rodriguez at the line to shoot two. 6 points tonight, 2 of 2 from the stripe, make it 3 of 3.
That's how they're going to have to close this game out. It's not going to be done on the perimeter. They have to go right at Capitol, be a little bit more aggressive, see if you can get – you've got 2 or 3 guys in foul trouble right now. Go right at them, see if you can get them out of the game. But no more jump shots. No more settling for that.
Rodriguez hits them both. Pushes the lead back out to 6. Coach Green giving one of the officials an earful and I think may have gotten a warning over on the Capitol bench. Hines calling out the play. Barclay has the hot hand. Robinson trying to set a screen. They can't get it. Hines back out top. Checked by Wilson.
Oh.
Finds Bennett underneath for the easy lay-in.
Good vision right there.
Elijah Bennett with 19 points for the Cougars. Back to 4 with 4 minutes and change to go. Rodriguez wants to challenge Hines, and he'll lay it up and in. Not a whole lot Hines could do about it. And 10 points for Nate Rodriguez. And now it's turned into a chess game. Hines.
Rodriguez got to be careful.
Three and drills it as Keon Likens. That is his first basket since the first quarter.
Lead is at 3. Rodriguez on that last one, though, tried to do a reach and tried to knock the ball away. He can get called for another foul and be out of this game.
Rodriguez goes in, can't get it to go. Matthew Stonecker can't get it to go back in. And the Capitol Cougars come out of this with a chance to tie this game up. Hines jumper is well short. Stonecker comes away with it, tries to lob it ahead to Wilson. And it goes out of bounds and stays with PHS, much to the chagrin of the Capitol fan.
Ball
this
control.
This one has gotten toit.
Yeah, let me tell you. Cheese is binding.
Here's Rodriguez out top, working against Hines. Trying to get a screen from Walker. Jumper from Rodriguez is good. And Nate Rodriguez trying to take this game into his own hands here to close it out. 5-point lead for the Big Reds. Cougars will work it around. 3-pointer from Likens is blocked. Back out to Hines. He'll fire a 3, and that's off the mark. Rebound, Matthew Stolnicker. And the Big Reds have the ball and a 5-point lead at 2:45 left in the ball game.
That is the stop that they needed.
Rodriguez goes past Robinson but misses the layup. Rebound, Bennett. Back up the floor for Likens for 3 and whistled for a foul. Likens misses it, but he's going to go to the stripe to shoot 3. Andrew Stolnicker picks up his 3rd foul, team foul 1, and we will see Keon Likens at the line to shoot 3. 5 points tonight for Likens. A layup in the first and a triple just about a minute ago. First one's good. Both teams have shot well from the charity stripe tonight.
PHS has had a few more opportunities than Capitol, but yes.
Second one rolls home. Tinsley in for Bennett. And Isaac Daly will check back in for PHS as Isaiah Walker heads out. Likens 3 in a row, and it's a 2-point PHS lead with 2.5 to go. Big Reds break the press into the front court. It's Wilson, waits for the reserves.
Take some time, milk some seconds off of this clock.
And Tinsley's going to go out to challenge Rodriguez to make him have to do something. Rodriguez charges in, tries to make the pass, but a whistle. And it's going to go on Tyleek Tinsley. It's his third foul, team foul three.
Are they calling that a shooting foul?
Oh, my gosh. Are they calling that? That's probably what Coach Green's saying. I thought it was a pass. They're calling it a shooting foul, and Rodriguez on the line, and he missed it.
Well, this is – I mean, Coach Green can be upset all he wants about it, but this stops the clock, and then he got the added benefit of Rodriguez missing the free throw.
12 points for Rodriguez, now 13, as he hits one of two, lead back to three. 2 minutes and change. Quick three the other way. Likens hits it! And we're tied at 76. Walker on the other end. Back out to Rodriguez, and we've got a fresh game, Mike, with 1:54. Here's Rodriguez off glass and good.
You're right, Brian. Rodriguez is trying to take over this game for PHS.
15 points for Rodriguez, most of it here in the fourth. Three from Likens the other way! And Capital has their first lead of the game at 79-78 and a minute and a half to play. And picked by Capital at the other end and a whistle. They get a timeout or a foul? It's going to be a foul. Andrew Stahlnicker picks up his fourth, team foul two. Capital ball, 1:25 on a stop clock, and it's a one-point Cougar lead. Are you serious right now? Hines will inbound. Pressure from the Big Reds. Into Bennett. Driving, off glass, no good, is Likens and a whistle. And is it going to go on Tinsley? That'll be his fourth. Team foul four. So the Big Reds are one foul away, or excuse me, Capital one foul away from putting the Big Reds on the line. Pressure from the Cougars up one. Minute 13 to go. Keon Likens with 3 three-pointers and 3 free throws all in this quarter to give the Cougars the lead. Yeah, the three-pointer he missed, he was fouled on.
Yes.
Got him the hard way. Hard screen by Stahlnicker. Give and go, and he is fouled and will go to the line to shoot two. Stahlnicker, Matthew Stahlnicker, sets a hard screen for Rodriguez. Little pick and roll action. And that is going to go on who? Is that Tinsley?
I think it's on Bennett.
Whoever it was their fifth, I think.
Well, if that's the case, well, they haven't escorted anybody off the floor yet.
Matthew Stahlnicker hits the first. He's got 20 points. I thought they said it was foul number five. It's maybe team foul five.
Or foul on number five, because it was Bennett. I think it was Bennett.
You think it was Bennett?
Yeah. Okay.
Hits them both. Timeout Big Reds with a one-point lead. Big Reds with one timeout left. Capital with two. 80-79. You paid for the whole seats, but you only need the edge, baby. I didn't think I was going to get to use it tonight, but here we are. Capital at 2-5 on the season. PHS 3-8. And this one's going to come down to the last couple possessions. Got a good one here for you on a Tuesday night at the Fieldhouse.
7 of 12 shooting for Capital, but 6 of those shots have been three-pointers. Made three-pointers.
Unreal. Keon Likens, 2 points in the first quarter, and that was it until the fourth quarter. And he's dropped 12 in the fourth. 4, 6, 8. Nate Rodriguez has put in 9 points in the fourth quarter.
Need a stop, obviously. I mean, that's elementary, my dear Watson, but they have been few and far between. So Coach Wilson's got to draw up a nice defensive play here that ensures Capital will not make a score on this possession.
Only two team fouls for PHS, so they're not close to putting anybody on the line just yet. It'll be Cougar basketball.
And they've gone away from the trap that was so good in the second and third quarters
to just straight up. Here's Tayshawn Hines for Capital, trying to get a good shot. Over to Likens, back out to Hines. A little lofty. Here's Barclay for three. He has been quiet lately, missed it. Knocked out of bounds, and Big Red basketball. Barclay had been hot. He's got 23. And now Capital is going to have to foul and put the Big Reds on the line if they can't get a quick turnover here with 30 seconds left. Stonecker into the front court to Walker. Over to Stonecker. Missed the layup. Capital ball with 20 seconds left. Hines out top. Capital has two timeouts. Barclay for three. Off the mark. Bennett with the rebound. His putback won't go. Stonecker with the rebound to Daly. Into the front court and a foul on Likens to stop the clock at 6 seconds. Likens with his third foul.
You just did a crack. You did a little voice crack there.
I forgot to breathe there for a second. So Daly's going to go to the line to shoot two.
Oh, my.
I think
goodness.
We've got some officials saying, all right, fellas, let's pump the brakes here a little bit. I know it's a hot game here with 6 seconds left. Daly's got two to shoot.
Oh.
Missed the first. He has been hot from everywhere, but that is his first free throw, and he missed it. It is going to be a one-possession game. Capital has two timeouts after this free throw. Missed them both.
And an offensive rebound.
PHS got it. Capital trying to foul, and they will get the foul with 2 seconds left. And Matthew Stonecker will go to the line.
One of the few things that has gone very right for PHS in the latter half of this game is their ability to get that second and sometimes third opportunity. And I'm telling you right now, Stonecker, both the Stonecker brothers, probably have double figures in offensive rebounds in this game.
Matthew Stonecker, 21 points, 3 of 3 from the stripe tonight with 2 seconds left. And I believe Tinsley may have just fouled out. David Robinson will come in for Capital. So Matthew Stonecker has a chance with his rebound and with his two free throws here to save this game for PHS.
That was huge because they had plenty of time. Oh, my.
Shorted it.
They had plenty of time to set up something. They had 6 seconds off of that missed free throw. But now with the offensive rebound, they were able to milk a couple seconds off. Stonecker has to get this one.
And hits that one.
Well, I guess it really doesn't matter because 2.4 seconds, you're probably going to see a desperation shot of some sort. And if that falls, it's going to be three. So I guess he could have missed that one.
Capital
wasted a little more time.
Yeah, I don't know. I'd almost rather have – you know that Capital was going to call a timeout.
Right.
So it's a two-point game. Capital burns a timeout. They have one left. PHS has one left.
This is amazing.
2.5 seconds on the clock. I'm spent. I'm Brian. That's Mike. I'm exhausted. What a game.
I have no words. I have no words.
And you know, the Cougars are going to be kicking themselves because they literally spotted PHS an 18-point
lead. They did. But there have been also opportunities during this game that PHS could have probably put it away, as ugly as it has been, but missed the gimme down there. Three free throws missed. So, yeah, they're having a tough time putting it away, but they have 2 points something to defend here.
And the Big Reds are going to put the tallest guy they can find, Connor Gribble, to guard the inbound. Whatever is going to happen, it's going to happen quick for the Cougars. Robinson to inbound.
He used
and
four.
Coach Green is going to have to burn his last time out.
Well, he used 4.5 of the 5 count, so it was a good it was a good call by Coach Green to do so.
Well, now you see how PHS is going to defend you, so maybe you can draw up something different.
Well, they had Barclay down here, and they had one of the Stalniger brothers saying, "You're not leaving my sight." He goes, I want to know what flavor gum that you're chewing right now, because you aren't getting away from me.
But the worst thing I would think, and just to play devil's advocate here, the worst thing that could happen is fouling somebody on a three-pointer, especially a desperation three-pointer.
Very much so.
I would think the Big Reds have to be very aware of, they're going to try and put something up and create contact. Do not touch them, because if you put them on the line on a garbage three-point attempt,
right,
and that's how this game is lost, you're just gonna kick yourself. Big Reds want the fans in it. This is gonna be the ball game. No more timeouts for Capital. One left for PHS.
Barclay in the far corner, and Stalniker's on him. And again, they got the tall kid in front of Robinson.
They've spread the floor into Bennett. Back to Likens, going to heave it for three, and the win off the back iron. Likens had a great look at it.
He had a perfect look at it.
Couldn't get it to go. And that's going to be the ball game, 81-79. The Big Reds survive and escape with a win. Move their record to 4-8. Capital going to drop to 2-6, but holy cow, what a fight from these Cougars.
And you know what, hats off, you know, whatever. Hats off to Capital right now. They could have just said, you know what, we'll go grab some pizza after the game. Yeah, what we had a
not our night.
just they came back,
up.
They clawed back, they shot the ball so well in that second half. They gave themselves a chance when that chance should not have been there.
Wow, 81-79. What an entertaining game. Wow. You're going to remember that one.
No.
My goodness, glad you joined us for that one. I hope you got here. Hope you stayed.
Now I need to find out where the defibrillators are.
My goodness. That one took a lot out of me. But hats off to both of these teams. They played their guts out.
That was a great
from
game.
From start to finish. My goodness. 81-79. Glad you joined us for that one. We are back on it on the air back here at the Fieldhouse on Friday night, and we'll have the PHS girls taking on George Washington, another visitor from the land down south.
All right.
In town to take on the PHS girls. So make sure you join us Friday night. Should be another good one here at the Fieldhouse. A great one tonight. So entertaining. 81-79. PHS survives Capital. For Mike Cameron, I'm Brian Guthrie, and the whole CAS 45 crew, thanks for watching.
Woo.
Good night, everybody.